Hello students, welcome to e-classes from PNMSRI High School. We will continue with our chapter number 1, exercise 1.2, sum number 8. Sum number 8, a student multiplied 7236 by 65 instead of multiplying by 56. By how much was his answer greater than the correct answer? Hint: do you need to do both the multiplication? In this sum, what is given? That a student has multiplied a number, that is 7236 by 65. Instead of that number, the student should have multiplied the number by 56. By mistake, he has multiplied the number by 65. So we have to find out how much was his answer. His answer will come by multiplying 7236 by 65. How much is his answer greater than the correct answer? Correct answer we will get by multiplying 7236 by 56. Now we will start solving our sum number 8. So in this sum, first of all, we have to multiply the number 7236 by both the numbers. That is by 65 and by 56 both. So the number by which the student multiplied, here first we have to find out the number by which the student multiplies. The student multiplies the number by 65. So 7236 multiply by 65. We will get 470,340. By calculating 7236 by 65, we will get 470,340. So now the number by which student should have multiplied. The student was supposed to multiply by the number by 56. So now we will calculate what the student get after multiplying the number 7236 by 56. We will do the calculation. 7236 multiplied by 56. We get the answer 405,216. Now to find out the student's answer was greater than the correct answer, first you have to find out the difference between both the products. The difference between both the products means we have to subtract the number which we get by multiplying 7236 by 65 and the number which we get by multiplying 7236 by 56. We get 470,340 by multiplying 7236 by 65. And we get 405,216 by multiplying 7236 by 56. We will subtract these two numbers. By subtracting these two numbers, we get the answer 65,124. By subtracting these two numbers, we will get 65,124. So the student's answer was greater than the correct answer by 65,124. Now we will move to our next question, sum number 9. To stitch a shirt, 2 meter 15 centimeter cloth is needed. Out of 40 meter cloth, how many shirts can be stitched and how much cloth will remain? Hint: convert data in centimeter. Now in this question, what is given is a shirt means one shirt requires 2 meter 15 centimeter cloth. Out of 40 meter cloth, that is total cloth the person has is 40 meter cloth from which he has to make shirts, and one shirt requires 2 meter 15 centimeter cloth. Now what we have to find out is how many shirts can be stitched and how much cloth will remain after stitching shirts, how much cloth will remain. And hint here it is given is we have to convert meters into centimeter. Solution for sum number 9. Now total length of cloth is 40 meter. That is given in the question that the total length of cloth is 40 meter. Now this 40 meter we have to convert into centimeters. As it is given in the question, to convert the data into centimeters. Students, as you all know that 1 meter is equals to 100 centimeters. So 40 meter is equals to 4000 centimeter. Next, length of the cloth required to stitch a shirt is equals to 2 meter 15 centimeter. A shirt means one shirt. To stitch one shirt, the person requires 2 meter 15 centimeter of cloth. Now this 2 meter also we have to convert into centimeter. 2 multiplied by 100 centimeter plus 15 centimeter is equals to 200 plus 15 centimeter is equals to 215 centimeter. So to stitch one shirt, the person requires 215 centimeter of cloth. So students, what was asked in the question is how many shirts can be prepared from the cloth and how much cloth remain after preparing a certain number of shirts. To find out the number of shirts, what we have to do is we have to divide the total cloth by the length of the cloth required to prepare a shirt. So we will divide 4000 by 215. So we can show the calculation like divide 4000 by 215. We will get the answer 18. So 18 shirts can be stitched and 1 meter 30 centimeter cloth will remain. Try to do question number 10 by yourself. So here we end our video and we'll continue our chapter in the next video. Thank you.